हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू हाउ टू हैंडल फाइल्स विथ C++। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो सेशन आई एम ट्राइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू राइटिंग ऑन अ फाइल्स, राइट एज अ प्रिमिटिव ऑपरेशन ऑन अ फाइल इन C++। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंसेप्ट, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू to subscribe my channel Tech Talks. If you have not subscribed yet, then please do subscribe my channel. Keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of new videos from my channel. Now let's start with the primitive operations. What do you mean by primitive operations on it? First of all, the primitive operations are nothing but they are useful to handle the files. They are to create a file. If the file is not exist, then we can create a file. Then after creating a file, we can perform different operations on it, or we will make use of that file, and at the end we will close the file. If the file is already exist, we can open a file. We will make use of that file by performing operations like reading or writing onto the file, and after that we will close the file. So these are nothing but the primitive operations that we can perform on a file. In this video session, I am focusing on writing on the file. Before moving forward, I would like to request you to keep in mind that before using all these things, you should have to include the IOStream and FStream header files in your C++ source code, because without including these files, you can't move further, you can't perform any of the remaining task. Let's start with the next important concept from the file handling, is nothing but a file pointer. File pointer is always maintained with every file which you are going to open to perform any of the task, because always the file pointer is helpful to keep the track of the current position of the cursor in the file. It keeps the track of the current position of the cursor from the current file, which helps us to perform different read operation as well as write operation. At which position we can write down, from which position we want to read, all these things are very easy with the help of file pointer FP. We need to keep in mind, whenever you are going to perform any of the reading or writing operation, that file pointer is automatically get increased with the next position. That we, the programmer, don't bother about the advancement of the file pointer. It automatically advances to the next position. Now let's start with the primitive operation, that is writing onto the file. Here I am trying to explain you that how are we going to perform the writing information to the file. Here I am explaining you it with the help of example. Suppose I am having three separate variables who are having three separate values in that. Say the variable x is having value 10, variable y is having value 25, z is having value 40. If I want to write this data onto the file, so what I will do, with the help of file pointer, I will copy the content of variable into the file. After copying the first variable, I will move forward, means the file pointer will get advanced and you can paste here the second variable. File pointer will get advanced automatically, and here you can paste the third variable. So in this way, data is copied from the variables into the file is nothing but the write operation onto the file. But how are we going to perform all these things? So for that, we are having a special operator with us, is nothing but the insertion operator. Up till now, if you have done the programming with C++ language, you must knowing this operator, insertion operator, that you have used with the cout statement. In the same way, we are going to use the same operator, but here only, instead of cout, we will use the object or a file pointer of the stream, OF stream or the F stream. because OF stream is responsible for the outputting of the data onto the files, is nothing but the writing data onto the file, and F stream can perform both the operations, that is input as well as output. So that's why object of the OF stream or F stream is useful while using this insertion operator instead of cout object. So in this way we can do the things. Here I am going to explain you all these things with the help of example. Here I am opening my file in out mode. What does it mean? I am creating this file with the help of file pointer out file. This is nothing but the file pointer is created with the stream OF stream or with the class OF stream class. So this is nothing but the object of OF stream that we are going to use as a file pointer. And with this file pointer only I can open my file, that is the file name is my first parameter a file dot dat, and the another parameter is nothing but the opening mode. If you want to know about how to open a file, if you don't know how to open a file, how to create a file, so please go through my video where I have already explained the primitive operation open and close file. Another one, if you don't know about the opening modes of the file, that I have already explained in the video, that is file opening modes. I am providing you the shortcut link in these right up corners. So now here I am assuming that all of you are knowing all these things, and now we are trying to write the content onto the file. Here I have opened a file in write mode. Then whatever you want to write, that you are going to accept it from the user. So here I am asking you to write down your name, and that I am going to accept it from the user, and that will get stored into the variable data. Now I want to write this data, whatever the content in available in this variable data, that I am going to try to write down onto the file. So for that, as I explained previously, this insertion operator I am going to use with the file pointer or the object of OF stream, and with the help of this, the out file is the file pointer associated with the a file dot dat. So that's why this data, whatever I am going to write down, will get write onto the a file dot dat. So now in this way I have written the name. Whatever you are going to take as input as your name will get write onto the file. After that I am asking to accept the age. You are going to accept the age. After that I am going to write down this content, whatever are accepted by you in the data variable, that I am going to write down onto the file with again the insertion operator onto the same file, that is a file dot dat. Here you have to keep in mind that externally I am not going to incrementing the out file pointer. It is get advanced to the next position automatically, and at the end, after performing all the required tasks, it is best practice that we have to close the file. So how to close the file, what happens after closing the file, is already explained in my previous video where I have already explained the close function. You can go through that. And it releases the memory, and here I am closing the file with whom this out file pointer is associated. Means in short, I am closing the a file dot dat. So in this way we can perform the write operation onto the file. So thank you dear friends. After that I am trying to explain you where I can explain that the which applications are or can be implemented with the help of this write primitive operation. So whenever I want to write the data, I can update the content of the file. If I am having the file of in which the information of the students are available, and if I want to update any name of the any of the student, then I can perform the update operation by using the write primitive operation onto the file. After that, the another thing which I can do with this write operation is nothing but the deletion of the data. In this deletion of the data, it's divided into two parts. That is, The searching part is nothing but the reading from the file, but once you get the required record which you want to delete from the file, for that you are going to delete. Means what? You will make a new file where you will paste all the records except the record which you want to delete. So in this way you can perform the delete operation, where you can use the write operation onto the file. So in this way, these are the applications can be implemented with the help of primitive operation write. Thank you friends for listening and watching my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel. In here I am providing you a subscription link. Here I am providing you the link for the next video from this video series, and here I am providing you the playlist for the same video series. Thank you friends, please stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. Thank you.